Hi, welcome to this new video tutorial on Jasper Report. Today I'm going to show you how you can create a table of contents in your report using a feature called Jasper Report Book. This is one of the features that is not really known to many of the new users of the Jasper Report. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you. In order to avoid having a long tutorial, I've decided to split it into two parts. In the first part, I will show you how you can create the first design and adding the table of contents. And the second part, I will show you how you can add your contents, build your reports, compile it, run it, and see it. So, at the end of this report, you are going to get something like this one, where you have a cover page, the table of contents, and the report itself. And at the one here, you have the back cover. Here is your back cover page. And when you come here to the table of contents, if you come here, for example, and go to German, here is in page 15. If you click here, so you can see here it's coming to German, and same thing can also go to Norway. If you click in page 24, you can see here that this page here is link. You can see how the icon change. We click there and we go here to Norway. So here is what you are going to do at the end of this. You are going to obtain at the end of this tutorial. So if something that we are looking for, stay tuned for this first part. Without a further delay, let's open our Jasper report. Go here and create a new project. Select Jasper Report Studio, then here Jasper Report Projects. New and enter the name. Here we are going to call it Jasper Report Book TOC. Tutorial. Then click next. Then here is our empty projects with a default Jasper report GRE, Java GRE, then the Jasper report libraries and the Jasper server libraries. So then here we are going to create our report book. We go here to new Jasper reports, and here instead of using this blank report, here you are going to this category here called report book, and in report book we are going to select the abstract book. Then next, here we select our project name. Here the name is abstract book. We click next, and then here you select the database. We use the sample database here. Then the table that we are going to use for this one is going to be this order. So here we select a dummy. Here we just enter a dummy query as dummy from orders limit one. So we are going to select only one rows here. This is just a dummy query. We click next. Here we select our dummy field, then click next here. So be careful, here is where everything is being played. Here the book is having many sections. You have the cover sections, the table of contents, and the back cover. We select them all, then click next. Congratulations, your first abstract report is ready for use, but not yet over. Then now, what do you see here? You see that here inside our library here we have 4JRXML files, abstract book, the back cover, the cover, and the TOC contents. And we can see the canvas here is having three sections. Here the first one is having the cover and the table of contents. Here our contents will go here. Then is our back cover. For this first part here, we are going to do this one. What time is it now? 45 minutes, we still have some times. So we select our abstract book, double click on that, and then we have this page. What we are going to do here is to decide this one. Otherwise, if you don't do that, you are not going to be able to see. I will show you anyway during the demonstrations in the second part. So what we do now is just select this one, select page number, select this field, select that one, select these three fields in details two. Details three is having only two fields, and then we come downstairs here and decide them. Here we are going to click none. Here you can see it's empty. And just after that one, you can see that we see, instead of what we had before, if you can bring your video earlier, you see that now we are able to see the fields labeled and so on. This is because you have destyled it. You have destyled the table of contents. So one thing that we can do for sure is to select them. Select this field, select that, select that. Oh, okay, you come back still that one during the design time. So then that is it, we save it now. Yeah, let's do that again and try that. Select all field, select this one, select that one. Then now we can come here to the field. And at yeah, change the fonts, something that is more acceptable. Same thing will go here to table of contents. We can come here again and really style it. Centralize it and bold. This is small. We can still increase the font to 20. Yeah, it's table of contents. Now, if we preview our table of contents. So here is what we have. Until now, our table of contents is empty. So not bad. We go here, select this abstract book. If we preview it, we can see that here we have you have these four sections here. Here is our book. Here is our table of no, sorry, this is already going to the other reports. So we close everything. Sorry, we close everything. Yeah. And then we come here to our reports book, abstract book, and preview it. So we have here only a single page is there. Then we are almost going there. So our first sections, our first part will stop here. We have created, somehow we have created the projects, and then a sample query inside, and then select all the three sections here that we have here. And now we have come here to this. We have come to the designs here and destyle this table of contents so that we can see the labels. So, thank you for watching, and let's see the second part of the tutorial. Bye.